Hi, today I'm going to show you how to preserve hydrates for morphology and for molecular work. Let's start with morphology. You are going to need formalin 4%. You're going to find the recipe for this formalin on the protocol below. Vials of different sizes depending on your colony, menthol crystals, and tweezers. This is a colony of hydrates that I've collected in the field and I want to preserve in formalin. We're going to add just one small crystal, a menthol crystal. Menthol crystal will relax the polyps. You can drop it in the water and let it sit for a while. You will see the polyps will relax and will be unresponsive. You can check under the microscope or under the stereoscope to make sure they're completely relaxed. This can take up to half an hour or so. Once you're sure that the polyps are completely relaxed, you can now preserve them in formalin. I've already prepared a vial with a label. Of course, you can label the vial as it is more convenient for you. You can take the colony and drop it in the formalin. Your vial is now ready. Now we're going to preserve part of this colony in ethanol for molecular analysis. You will need ethanol, 96% to 100%, and tweezers. It's very important that the tweezers, as well as the glassware and the plasticware, have never been in contact with formalin, because formalin can interfere with molecular work. I have already a vial with a label and it's already filled with ethanol. You can label, of course, the sample the way it's more convenient for you. You can get your polyps and drop them directly in the ethanol. You don't need to relax them because all you need is the tissue for your molecular analysis. You can drop them there. You want to make sure they're not too full of polyps and there is enough ethanol for the tissue you're preserving. Your sample is now ready. I suggest you prepare two vials for each species you collect, one in formalin for further molecular analysis and to identify the species, and one in ethanol for molecular analysis.